Hello, my name is Jorge Lopes, this is Marcelo Norberto, and we are going to talk about VirtualSign Translator in serious games.
This project has been developed in GILT. This stands for Games Interaction and Learning Technologies. It's a research group inside ESA, and this is this university. And so, This project consists, the virtual sign consists in an implementation of a Portuguese sign language bidirectional translating system. That means you'll be translating text to gestures using the avatar you are seeing on the right side of the screen over there. And you also translate gestures that people will perform to our system and turn that into Portuguese text. In order to achieve this goal, we have to have a stronger insight of how Portuguese sign language works. So we did some research and we found out that there's some main parameters that we needed to attend. That is that one of them is that there are manual and non-manual components. So it's not just about the ends and the and that that we need to observe and to take into consideration for sign language. So, as for the manual components, we have four main topics that we take in consideration when classifying gestures. That is that there is a hand configuration, that's like position of the fingers. The hand orientation is the direction the hand is pointing. The articulation position, we base it on the wrist, and the hand movement. As for the non-manual components, there is the body movement, the tilting the body forward and back means changes the sentence to the future or the past for the sentence test. And the facial expression works as or as exclamation marks, for instance, and the mood if the person sings angrily or if it's happy, and it gives mood to the sentence. So this project has three main modules. As I said in the beginning, there is a sign-to-text translation. There is a text-to-gesture using the avatar. And we included a didactic game, a serious game. This game was created in order to allow people to learn some basics on sign language, because there's still a huge lack of digital material in this area. Here's a small video of our translation from gesture to text. The person performs the gestures. We use those gloves and Kinect. I'll explain in the next slide. And on the right top, there's the words being detected. And on the bottom, it shows statistics of the percentage of how sure the program is of the result of the words that are showing the screen. So in order to do this, we use the sensor 5VT gloves. There are gloves with 14 sensors, I think. Those provide information we need about the end configuration. So it gives us our finger position. And then we use the Kinect for basically all the other aspects, for hands orientation, the body movement, and the facial expression. So, we had the software and we had a small basis of how it works, but we needed to turn this into something easier to implement. So what we did was divide and conquer. So how does sign language work? And to figure out that there's always a configuration associated with a movement. That movement can be non-existent, but this way it's easier to classify. So the beginning of a gesture is always defined by a configuration of the dominant hand. And the ending of the ending of this gesture is also specified by configuration. And we discovered that there's only 57 different configurations. What made this job a lot easier, because you can just have a base for the configurations and then add the movement, and you don't have to have an infinite number of gestures, and instead you have configurations associated with movement. So those gloves, that the sensor gloves, provides information of the end, and that gives us the estimation of the configuration. We take that information and we take the movement retrieved from the Kinect, and then comparing the various vectors of values, we can apply a sequence algorithm and compare and get some results. Here's an example of one of the gestures, the three gestures, I'm sorry. And I'll try to explain briefly how it works. Like, bon dia means good morning, and it's a big configuration. The supporting end in this gesture is not used, so it's not taken into consideration. And for the good morning, there's a B, and there's no movement, that's why the dot represents. And then it changes to an open hand configuration, and there's a movement associated with that. So we classify this configuration with no movement. Then when we change to this configuration, we're going to see what movement was done with this configuration, and was this movement. And so we got the configuration from the gloves, the movement from Kinect, and we can then classify the system. So this thing stands for good night from the side. So here's the result. And we also have this already implemented so we can understand sentences. So if a person says good morning and then another word after that, we will classify like from the biggest to the shortest one. We analyze and we compare. If there's not a match with that, it's because if that's not a sentence or a word, that's probably a series of words. So we reduce and we start classifying less. So we have three configurations, and that doesn't make any sense in sign language for this case. So we analyze two instead, and two has a match. It's good morning. So that's how we are creating sentences. We are checking if there's a match with the longer sequence. If there's not, we reduce and we classify again and again until we have a positive match. As for the not metal component, the body movement is, like I said, it's being retrieved by the Kinect. All the movement of the person is being retrieved using this device. And we are now creating a facial expression classifier. This component is the text to gesture. Basically what it does is the user just has to type text and it will be performed by the avatar as gestures. This example of the video is a chat that you're looking at right now. It's a long distance chat. It's like two different people could connect each other and send the data. This is sending information directly from the Kinect to the translator, and this is the normal translator. You just type in the data, you press translate, and the avatar is going to translate everything that was typed into the box. In order to achieve this part of the translator, we had to get an avatar. We use this avatar that you see in the image. All the animations were created manually on Blender, the animations for the gestures. And we made sure that those animations could be used with any avatar that have a similar humanoid bond structure. The translator, we also created a system that's like an orthographic corrector system, because deaf people do have a hard time reading, because their language sentences are built in a different way from the traditional Portuguese. So since there are words that are not, that they don't use or are in switched orders, they have a hard time reading. And therefore, they have our writing as well. So we have an orthographic system that helps them when they make mistakes. We also created the PowerPoint add-in that that's how the videos you're seeing on the corner now, those are videos, but they were recorded with an engine we created. So it's basically our translator running at the same time as a PowerPoint. And you just press, you start a presentation in PowerPoint, and it will highlight the the words. Yeah, as you can see there, like the bon dia is in blue. That's what's being translated directly in our app as the presentation was going. It's an add-in you can put in any presentation. You just put a tag and then it starts translating all the text in PowerPoint and sending it to our application, and the avatar will perform the gesture corresponding to the word highlighted. This is a picture of the chat I mentioned before. So we have a chat. You have to connect to someone through IP, and then you just write the text, and the person that receives the text will see the text plus the avatar performing the gesture. Because, like I said, they have a hard time reading. That's why we also implemented a version of Kinect with this, so they can actually use the Kinect instead of typing to what they want. And then finally we got the series game that integrates both the gesture to text and text to gest. We use the animations that we had in the avatar and we use the recognition of the Kinect. These are some of the scenarios. This is right now is the first scenario in the map. The player has to obtain gestures that are scattered all over the map, and the faster he obtains them, the bigger the score. There's also mini games and challenges that he has to overcome in order to proceed. This is the second level. The first level, I'll say for the first level is word, second is first level is letter, second word, and third sentences. This is the words level. So, for this game, we defined that we will have these three levels. So we have three different sign language learning things, like I said. Letters, words, letters, numbers, then words, then sentences. Of course, we don't teach all of them. We choose some of the most used words and sentences. As for letters, we have all of them, of course. We implemented multi-mini games in order to make the game more appealing. And, of course, we integrated the translator in the game. So we made sure to create large maps, so the user has a big environment. We wanted this is a serious game, so it had to have intuitive gameplay. The user can't rage quit from the game. It needs to be able to play it without much effort. It needs to be challenging, but not in a way that the user will quit from it. We have a inventory system. That's where the gestures are kept. So, in the image you can see in the corner, there's like a D. The user just clicks the gestures and the avatar will translate it. And you have a checkpoint system. This is a signature from the first scene, the first scenario. As you can see, it's a bit large. And here's where the user will learn the alphabet and the numbers. And there's plenty of interactive app objects for the player to interact, and then you'll obtain gestures based on that interaction. As for the second scene, it's a free roaming scene. First level kind of has locked various checkpoints. In this area, it works more as a base of quest. So player will be required to get some gestures in order to get another gesture. And this level will teach a list of basic words, and player is free to choose the order of events. The third level, we use the scene that was provided by Unity. It's a futuristic scenario. And it teaches basic sentences. And it has some triggers that trigger minigames. Like, there are the NPCs you talk to, and then all of a sudden you're driving a car, for instance, in this level. You have a racing minigame. These are the scenarios of the evaluation scenes. As I said in the beginning, you created three learning scenarios and they created three evaluation scenes. Those are in between each level and they will check it's going to be kind of like a quiz to the user to check if they actually learn anything from it, if you retain some information from during playing the level. This image is the integration of the gesture to text translator. In the checkpoints, if the user chooses, the game has to, you can choose to play with the Kinect or just without it. If you play with the Kinect, in every checkpoint, you'll be asked to perform the gestures that you have obtained. And you have to perform them correctly in order to proceed. You can see the password needed, you can see very well, it's ACDH. And the guy in the image had already performed AC. And as soon as he performs the gesture, it's shown in the interface. So he knows if he's doing it right or wrong. Finally, these are the two examples of minigames that we have in the main game. One is it's a memory game with gestures, so you just click the card, you have to find pairs, you have to remember where they were and match them. And then we have, for instance, a 2D shooter, kind of like a space shooter game, that the user needs to get a score high enough in order to obtain a gesture in the end. And that's it.